Hey Breakers, it's Merlin. Welcome to the Talents Crash Course. First, I'll be going through them a little quickly, so feel free to pause and read through the figures for each level. Second, there's three categories, Mind, Body, and Spirit, and you've got 6 points to use, and each has its own cost. Two cost 1 point, two cost 2 points, and the last one costs three. You have the option of not picking any type, so you can pick the last gauntlet in two categories. Thirdly, your talent choices for a given class are saved for the next game, so don't worry about picking them up again if you're just going to use the same. And lastly, before getting into the talents, you level them up by collecting scrolls that randomly drop from chests throughout the match. They can also drop from opponents who've already collected some scrolls. Epic chests have a guaranteed chance to drop them. The first number you hear them call out is the base or passive level, and the three after that are going to be the values once you've collected one, two, or three scrolls for that category. First up is Mind. We've got Focus Mana, which increases your spell damage by plus 15, 18, 20, and 30%. Spell Slinger reduces the sorcery cooldown by 5, 8, 10, 15%, and carry an extra gauntlet and rune. Harmony, you have immunity to slow, shock, and freeze effects, as well as damage reduction of 5%, 7, 10, 15. Tracking, when you hit someone, you highlight them for you and your whole team for 3, 3.5, 4, and 6 seconds. Rune of Cluency gives you an extra rune charge, and the rune cooldown goes down by 5, 7, 10, 15%. Moving on to Body, there's Dexterity, you get plus 25% jump height, and levitation cost goes down by 15, 18, 20, and 30%. Scavenging, when you get an exile, you restore 25, 30, 35, 50 armor and HP. Feather, your spell cast speed goes up by 15, 18, 20, and 30%. Finders Keepers, the chance to drop a scroll increases by 50, 75, 100, and 150% chance. Fortitude creates a barrier that absorbs all damage from one source for a single hit. And the cooldown starts at 60, 50, 45, and 30 seconds after it pops. Lastly, we've got Spirit, there's Escapist. When you take damage, your run speed increases for 5 seconds by 2.3, 4, and 5 points. Recklessness, if you've got no armor, your spell damage goes up by 15, 18, 20, 25%, and your cost, i.e. your mana cost, goes down by 15, 18, 20, and 25%. Recovery, over 10, 9, 8, and then 5 seconds, you regenerate 50% of damage done to your HP. Thirsty, your armor, shard, and HP pot consumption rate goes up by 50%, 60%, 75%, and 100%. Vital Stone, once per game, if you reach 0 HP, i.e. if you're knocked, you'll be immune for 2 seconds, you can't attack either, and come back with 10, 25, 35, and then 50 HP, no armor. There's some talents that go well in all configurations, such as Runic Fluency or FF, but there are combos that work very well with specific classes. For a combo that I would use for aggressive playing, it would be something like Runic Fluency, Scavenging, and Thirsty. Extra rune charge and faster cooldown, gaining HP and armor with every exile, and quicker consumption of heals. Harmony, Feather, and Recovery is a great build for Stone Shapers. Shockwave more frequently, immune to slow, stun, and freeze effects, plus damage reduction, and regen 50% of all HP damage taken. That also works with the Storm too, by the way. As a Frostborn, something like Focus Mana, Fortitude, and Thirsty would work well for you. Your class revolves around doing damage from afar. With that config, you'll hit harder with full mana, negate the first hit you take, and consume heals quicker if they land a few shots on you before you're able to get out. Focus Mana, Feather, and Recklessness play into Toxicology style of high risk, high reward. You can hit over 150 damage with a single toxic slap if you're done correctly. If you're playing Condit or Tempest, Spell Slinger for the rune and gauntlet swapping is a near must. Fever also benefits these classes quite a lot, and Thirsty or Recovery are great to add as well. As for Pyromancer, there isn't a whole lot that synergizes super well with the class specifically, so general builds are quite solid. Apart from those suggested builds, I'd recommend mixing and matching talents until you find a build that suits your playstyle and class of choice. If you didn't catch anything that I said earlier, remember what I said, you can always go back, rewind, pause the video, and read up on the figures. Anyway, until next time, good luck in the Hololands, Breakers, and stay magical.